press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Well, dear students, in our previous class, we have considered the significance of the first law of thermodynamics. So let us go ahead with some of the important applications related with first law of thermodynamics. Well, see, in first law of thermodynamics, we come to know that if dQ is the amount of heat supplied to the system, the part of heat utilized for increasing the internal energy and the remaining part is utilized for doing some external work. And here, one of the limitation of first law of thermodynamics is that this law does not tell you that in which direction energy transfer takes place and what fraction of input energy or input heat energy is converted into work done cannot be analyzed using this equation. And the third important thing is this equation or this law does not tell you why the entire heat supply cannot be converted into work done. See, that is the limitation of first law of thermodynamics. Let us apply this law for various thermodynamic processes. First, let us take up isothermal process. Isothermal process. The process which takes place at a constant temperature is called isothermal process, which is already known to us. See, here pressure and volume of the gas changes, however temperature of the system remains constant. And this process is represented by the equation PV is equal to a constant. PV is equal to constant at constant temperature. Or this can also be written as P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 equals a constant. It is equal to constant. So when a liquid boils, when this liquid started boiling, its temperature doesn't change. Or when a solid melts into a liquid, there is no change in the temperature. Therefore, it is also an isothermal process. See, when you consider slow expansion of a gas, see, it is an isothermal expansion. Slow expansion of a gas enclosed in a cylinder fitted with a smooth frictionless piston is an example for isothermal expansion. Similarly, see, if you consider slow compression of a gas enclosed in a cylinder fitted with a smooth frictionless piston is also isothermal compression, right? So when you take this equation, see, here temperature remains constant. Since temperature remains constant, there is no change in the internal energy because U is constant. U is a constant. Internal energy is constant. Why? The reason is that temperature is constant. Since temperature remains constant in isothermal process, internal energy of the system also remains constant. Hence, change in internal energy equal to zero. Therefore, whatever heat supplied by U is utilized for doing some external work. Right? It is utilized for doing some external work. So let us obtain the expression for what is the work done. Okay. So let me consider a cylinder fitted with a smooth frictionless piston. Okay, like this. We have taken a gas, 1 mole of gas. So when heat is supplied to this gas, the gas expands. See, therefore, now the piston moves here. Say dx is the small displacement. Okay. What is work done? Work done is equal to work done by the gas in pushing the piston upwards through a very small distance dx is given by work done by the gas. By the gas, dW is equal to force into displacement. This is general formula. Force into displacement. This is known to you. What is force? Force can be expressed in terms of pressure into area. Pressure into area. And what is displacement? Displacement here is dx. P into A into dx. A into dx gives you change in volume, area multiplied by dx. This gives you change in volume. I indicate that by dv. See, therefore, work done becomes dw becomes equal to p into dv. See, this is the work done by the gas. Work done by the gas when the gas absorbs small quantity of heat. Small quantity of heat. Now let us consider the situation. Let the volume of gas is changes from initial volume V1 to final volume V2. Then what is the total work? And that's our intention. I want to determine what is the total work done when the volume of gas changes from V1 to V2. Total work done is given by W is equal to integral from V1 to V2 P into dV. Why we integrate this? Integration is just like summation. Integration is being employed in pure mathematics. I mean to say it is employed in the calculus. It is just like summation in your algebra. Okay. So here, we have added the small work done when the volume changes from initial volume V1 to V2. Instead of addition or summation in pure mathematics, we are making use of integration. Okay. This is called definite integrals, boundary from V1 to V2. Have you got my point? Well, let us make use of ideal gas equation because we have taken ideal gas. So we know that, let me take this equation 1, this one equation 1, this is equation 2. Using ideal gas equation, using ideal gas equation, PV is equal to mu into RT, where mu is the number of moles. I can write P is equal to mu into RT divided by V. See, therefore, equation 2 becomes W is equal to V1 to V2 mu RT by V into dV. See, in integration, there is a rule which says that integral from V1 to V2 are generally integral of 1 by V dV is equal to log V. See, this is the rule. Or integral of 1 by X dX is log X. Okay. Let us make use of this rule. here, so when you put this rule, we can get W is equal to mu RT, they are constants, integral from V1 to V2, 1 by V dV. You please integrate this, you are going to get mu into RT. See, this gives you log V. You must give the limit V1 to V2. Rule says that first you must give the upper limit and minus lower limit. Okay, that is the rule for definite integrals. W is equal to mu RT log of, in the place of V, first we have to put V2, minus log of V1. Here log base E. Okay, you must remember this is log base E. This is also indicated by ln. Log base E is also indicated by ln. Ln means natural is logarithm or natural logarithm, right? Log m minus log n gives you log m by n. See, therefore, this becomes equal to mu RT into logarithm of V2 by V1. See, this is the work done. This is the work done by the gas. See, therefore, during isothermal expansion, work done by the gas is given by mu RT into log of V2 by V1 to the base E. See, therefore, whatever heat supplied by you is completely converted into work done in case of isothermal expansion. Once again, I just explain this. Say here, work done is given by P into dV. We know that how we got this equation. Let us assume that the gas is expanding in such a way that volume is changing from V1 to V2. Let us make use of ideal gas equation PV is equal to mu into RT, where mu is the number of moles of gas. I can write P is equal to mu into RT divided by V. Equation 2 becomes work done is equal to integral from V1 to V2. So, integral symbol is like this. This is integral symbol. Okay. Integral from V1 to V2 mu RT by V into dV. Here I just take out the constant outside. When you integrate 1 by V with respect to V, you are going to get log V to the base E. Since this is a definite integral, you must give the limit for the final result you have obtained in definite integrals, right? So therefore, work done is given by mu RT into log of, in the place of V, I put upper limit first, V2 minus log of V1. Log M minus log N, according to rule of logarithms, it is given by log M by N. So therefore, the total work done by the gas during an isothermal process is given by mu RT log of V2 by V1 to the base E. Or even it can be written like this. This can also be written like this. W is equal to mu RT ln V2 by V1. Ln is natural logarithm. It is just like log E. Instead of writing log E, log to the base E, I just write ln. Ln is natural logarithm. As I told you here, see, they are same. So this is the total work done during an isothermal expansion. Here, the expansion took place at a constant temperature T Kelvin. That you must remember. Now, let us move on to work done in other processes. Let us take isochoric process. So the process which took place at a constant volume is called isochoric process. So here the volume is kept constant. So if you take a cylinder, if there is a cylinder and this cylinder is fitted with a smooth frictionless piston, but the piston is fixed, rigidly fixed. The piston is not movable, it is rigidly fixed. See, in such a situation, if you supply heat to the gas, here there is a gas, there is an increase in internal energy and piston cannot move because it is rigidly fixed. Volume is constant. See, therefore, since volume is constant, the work done is zero because you know that dW is given by P into dV. Here V is equal to a constant, which implies change in the volume. There is no change in the volume. Therefore, change in the volume is zero. Hence, total work done is zero. Whatever heat energy supplied by you, according to first law, is being completely utilized for increasing internal energy. See, therefore, there is no work done in an isochoric process. But whatever heat you supplied in utilized for increasing the internal energy of the system. Okay, that's about the isochoric process. Now let us move on to another important process, isobaric process. So in case of isobaric process, pressure of the given mass of gas kept constant. Here, pressure is kept. Here, P is equal to a constant. Since pressure is kept constant, whatever heat you supplied, it's utilized for not only increasing internal energy, also doing some external work. Have you got my point? So you will see that there is increase in the internal energy as well as external work done. Suppose if you take 1 mole of gas, constant pressure dQ is given by CpdT, where Cp is the molar specific heat capacity at constant pressure. dT is the rise in temperature. If the temperature increases by small value dT, then it is given by 1 m into CpdT. If I take 1 mole of gas, then CpdT. Have you got my point? And dU is one which is utilized for increasing the internal energy. Therefore, it is given by m into CvdT. So this is CvdT because I have taken 1 mole of gas. And dW here is, as you know, PdV, which is equal to RdT. PdV is equal to RdT. When you substitute all these values, you are going to get CpdT is equal to CvdT plus RdT, or Cp is equal to Cv plus R. See, this is also called Mayer's equation. This implies that Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So, the difference between molar specific heat capacity at constant pressure and constant volume, that difference is always equal to gas constant, universal gas constant. See, molar specific heat capacity. Cp minus Cv is always equal to R, gas constant. So now let us understand more about adiabatic process. So before going to that, I must tell you that where you can notice this process. Suppose if you take boiling of a liquid at the atmospheric pressure, it is an isobaric process because at atmospheric pressure, pressure remains constant. Therefore, it is an isobaric process. Remember, work done in isobaric process is always more compared to any other methods. Let us go to adiabatic process. The process which takes place under thermal isolation such that no heat enters the system nor leaves the system is called as adiabatic process. Adiabatic means not passing across. So see here, no heat enters the system from outside. And at the same time, heat from the system never goes outside. So in such a situation, when there is a change in pressure, volume and temperature occurs, we say that there is an adiabatic process. Let us take first law of thermodynamics, dQ is equal to dU plus dW dW. Here, no heat enters the system nor leaves the system. That means what? Q is equal to a constant. So, which implies dQ is equal to 0. Therefore, 0 is equal to dU plus dW or dU is equal to minus dW. See, therefore, during adiabatic process, if you take adiabatic expansion, when there is an adiabatic expansion, work is done by the gas. See, therefore, internal energy becomes negative. See, during adiabatic expansion, when you take adiabatic expansion, work is done by the gas. Work is done by the gas, or dW is positive, which implies dU increase. There is a decrease in the internal energy. Instead of increasing, there will be decrease in the internal energy of the system. Cooling effect is produced. For example, when there is a sudden expansion, if the balloon burst or if the tire burst, cooling effect is produced. When there is a sudden expansion, sudden expansion are usually adiabatic in nature. When there is a sudden expansion, there is a decrease in the temperature. That's what indicated here. dU becomes negative. If dU decreases, then there will be a cooling effect. If dU increases, there will be heating effect. So, increase in the internal energy result in the increase in temperature. Here, decrease in the internal energy leads to decrease in temperature. So, therefore, wherever there is an adiabatic expansion, work is done by the gas, in such a situation, cooling effect is produced. The most popular example is bursting of a balloon or bursting of a tire or sudden expansion. They are usually adiabatic in nature. Suppose if there is an adiabatic compression, so you know that when work is done onto the gas, we always take work done as negative. See, this is the sign convention we have adopted. When work is done onto the gas, we always take work done as negative. See, this implies that dU is positive. See, therefore, when there is a sudden compression, heating effect is produced. Suppose you are pumping air into the football, okay? Though air is being completely filled, if you try to compress it further, the pump itself got heated up. This heating up of the pump is mainly due to compression, adiabatic compression. Wherever there is a sudden compression of gas, heating effect will be produced. See, it is an example for adiabatic compression. Okay, this is the case of how we can use first law of thermodynamics to understand adiabatic process. Now let us calculate work done during adiabatic process. See, that's our intention. See, the most important thing we have to do. See, before that, I must tell you what are the equations which can be used to represent this adiabatic process. Okay, adiabatic process is represented by equation PV to the power of gamma equals a constant, or P1V1 to the power of gamma is equal to P2V2 to the power of gamma equals a constant. Where gamma is the ratio of molar specific heat capacity of gases. It's a ratio of molar specific heat of gas at constant pressure to molar specific heat of gas at constant volume. See, that ratio is indicated by gamma. See, gamma value varies from 1.67 up to 1.28.
up to 1.33. It depends on the atomicity of the gas that you will understand in the next chapter. The gamma value, say using the gamma value, you can decide atomicity of gas. You can understand the molecular constitution of gas. See, that's the significance of gamma, right? Okay. See, there are other ways also to we can write the expression for adiabatic process. For example, suppose if you take PV is equal to RT, PV is equal to RT, you can write V as RT by P. If you take 1 mole of gas, we can write like this, RT by V. When you put this here, P into, in the place of V, I just write RT by P whole to the power of gamma equals a constant. See, from this, you can write P to the power of 1 minus gamma, T to the power of gamma equals a constant. Or P1 to the power of 1 minus gamma, P1 to the power of gamma is equal to P2 to the power of 1 minus gamma, P2 to the power of gamma equals a constant. So this equation represents adiabatic process in terms of pressure and temperature. Pressure and temperature. They are all called equation of state. Remember, the equation which represents the state of the system is called equation of state. See, in case of adiabatic process, you can write PV to the power of gamma is equal to constant, or P1 V1 to the power of gamma is equal to P2 V2 to the power of gamma. This is one way. In terms of pressure volume, you can express like this. Suppose if you want to express in terms of pressure and temperature, we have the equation P to the power of 1 minus gamma into T to the power of gamma equals constant, or we can write like this. Suppose, let me substitute for P as P is equal to RT by V. So this is one equation. Remember this. This is second equation. We have third equation. Let us take this P. In the place of P, I just write RT by V into V to the power of gamma equals a constant. See, from this I can write T into V to the power of gamma minus 1 equals a constant. How? See, here V power is 1. Here V power is gamma. You just take to the numerator, it becomes like this. Or I can write T1 V1 to the power of gamma minus 1 equals T2 V2 to the power of gamma minus 1, which is equal to a constant. Have got my point? See, these are the three different equations which can be used to represent adiabatic process. Have you followed? Let us make use of this equation to obtain the expression for work done during adiabatic process. See, that's our intention. So you must remember all these equations, because see, in certain problems we require these results. While solving certain problems, we require these results. Expression for work done. Expression for work done. So you know that work done is given by PdV. See, this is the small, this general equation PdV. What is the total work done? Total work done is given by total work done. This is small work done when the piston is pushed upwards. Small work done. Total work done is given by integration, integral from V1 to V2 PdV. PdV. Let us substitute for V. See, but you know that PV to the power of gamma equals a constant. See, therefore, I can write P is equal to a constant divided by V to the power of gamma. Let us substitute here W is equal to integral from V1 to V2, a constant divided by V to the power of gamma into dV. Let us take out constant outside. Constant comes outside. Integral of V1 to V2, integral from V1 to V2. You just take to the numerator, V to the power of minus gamma into dV. See, there is a result in integration which says that if integral of x to the power of n dx is taken, the rule says that when you integrate x power n with respect to x, it is given by x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, right? Let us use that. W is equal to a constant comes outside. This is V to the power of minus gamma plus 1 divided by minus gamma plus 1, limit from V1 to V2. They have given the limits from V1 to V2. So let us make substitution. Let us give limit. This is a constant divided by 1 minus gamma. This is given by V2. I am substituting for V2 to the power of minus gamma plus 1 minus V1 to the power of minus gamma. This is work done. Have you followed? See, now let us substitute for constant. As P1 V1 to the power of gamma is equal to P2 V2 to the power of gamma equals a constant, I just take W is equal to, I just multiply this, 1 minus gamma, this is P2 V2 to the power of gamma into V2 to the power of minus gamma plus 1 minus P1 V1 to the power of gamma V1 to the power of minus gamma plus 1. See, in the place of a constant, I am substituting first this one, and in the next stage I am substituting that. So you please simplify this. Plus gamma, minus gamma got cancelled. What remains? 1 by 1 minus gamma. P2 V2 minus P1 V1. See, as PV is equal to RT, PV is equal to RT, this implies P1 V1 is equal to RT. And P2 V2 is equal to RT2 using the ideal gas equation. See, therefore I can write W is equal to 1 by 1 minus gamma RT2 minus RT1. Or you just take out minus sign outside, you can write 1 by gamma minus 1 R also outside. This gives you T1 minus T2. See, therefore, work done during adiabatic process is given by this relation. I once again explain this. See, this is a general expression we have derived. Work done in an expansion is given by, expansion of a gas is given by dW is equal to pdV, because there is a change in pressure, volume and temperature. Therefore, I just derived this equation previously. I accept this equation. This is already known to us. Now, the total work done when the volume changes from V1 to V2 is given by W is equal to integral of V1 to V2 pdV. In the place of P, I just substitute PV to the power of gamma equals a constant. See, therefore, P is equal to a constant by V power gamma according to adiabatic equation. So now you just simplify this, use this result, integral result, and simplify this. Then put this condition, again go through little simplification, you are going to get this final expression, W is equal to R divided by gamma minus 1 T1 minus T2. See, if the work done is positive, internal energy is negative in adiabatic expansion. In adiabatic compression, work done is negative, internal energy is positive. Therefore, heating effect is produced. See, therefore, during a sudden expansion, cooling effect is produced. It is an example for adiabatic expansion. When there is a sudden compression, heating effect is produced. See, there will be W will be negative. Okay. See, that's about adiabatic expansion. So you must remember these results for solving problems. Now we shall finally move on to cyclic process. See, the process which takes place in such a way that the system passes through different stages and finally returns back to the initial state. If that is the case, then we call that process as cyclic process. It may be passing through various stages, but finally it comes back to the initial state. For example, you have taken a cube of ice. You are supplying heat to the ice. It melts into water. When you continue heating, it started boiling and got converted into steam. As you started decreasing the temperature, steam condensed into water, and further condensation leads to conversion from water state to solid state. I mean, it got converted into ice, it got freezed out, water freezes into ice. So therefore, the system is being brought back to its initial configuration. This is a cyclic process. Okay, usually cyclic process should be carried out at the slow rate. So you cannot carry it out in a fast rate. Okay. So it should be carried out in a slow rate. See, then only you will be end up with the initial configuration of the system. So therefore, since the system is brought back to the initial configuration, here there is no change in the internal energy. So U remains a constant. The system is being brought back to the initial configuration, initial pressure, volume and temperature, initial status, initial state. See, that's why internal energy remains constant. Hence, this implies the change in the internal energy equal to zero. Hence, whatever heat supplied by you is utilized for doing some work. Therefore, this implies dQ is equal to dW. Hence, when you apply first law of thermodynamics, cyclic process can be represented by this equation, dQ is equal to dW. Have you followed? So let us understand how we can represent these processes, thermodynamic processes, diagrammatically. Okay, see, that's our next intention. You know, so here we represent by a PV diagram. It is also called indicator diagram. PV diagram or indicator diagram. Indicator diagram which represents the variation of pressure and volume under different set of conditions. Well, let us take one by one our isothermal process.
for isothermal process. So when you take the graph of pressure versus volume, see you will get a negative slope. The graph will be like this. Okay, the graph will be like this. This at a different temperature you will get different curves. See, we call them as isotherms. Suppose if it is at a temperature T1, it will be at temperature T2. See, they are called isotherms. Isotherms. Remember, area under this curve gives you work done. Area under PV diagram or indicator diagram gives you work done. Let us take the situation what happens during isochoric process. See, in isochoric process volume remains constant. See, therefore when you plot the graph, see, it will be like this. You will get the graph. Okay. See, when you take isobaric process. Work done is maximum because the graph is a straight line parallel to the volume axis. See, therefore, in this case, work done will be maximum. When you take adiabatic process, you will have the graph like this. It is much steeper compared to isothermal curve, it will be much steeper. Graph will be steep, right? Adiabatic. If you take finally cyclic process, it can be of any shape, but let me take this situation. Say this is a cyclic process. It may be triangular, or in the form of a rectangle, or it in the form of a square. In all these cases, say this area gives you the work done. Area of this loop gives you the work done. See, here it is not a closed graph, right? Or a closed curve, but this is a closed curve because the system is being brought back to the initial configuration, right? If the direction is in clockwise, then the work done is positive. If the direction is anti-clockwise, work done is negative. That is the sign convention. So remember, in thermodynamics we have a particular sign convention. Suppose if heat is absorbed by the system, then it is taken to be positive. If heat is given out by the system, it is an exothermic process, it is taken to be negative. Heat absorbed positive, heat given out is negative. That's one thing. Work done by the system is positive, work done onto the system is negative. If the system does some work, then we take that work done as positive. If gas is being compressed, say we are doing some work on the gas. So therefore, in such a case, work done is taken to be negative. If internal energy increases, it will be positive. If internal energy decreases, it will be negative. See, these are the sign convention which are need to be followed while solving problems related to thermodynamics in physics. So let us put all these on a single PV diagram. See, it can be written as like this. PV. If you take this as isobaric process, this is isobaric curve. See, this will be isotherm. isotherm. This will be adiabatic. And this will be isochoric. Therefore, in these three cases, work done under the curve is maximum only in case of isobaric process. Isobaric process. And work done is zero in isochoric. Therefore, work done in isobaric greater than work done in isothermal, which is greater than work done in adiabatic process. That you must remember. See, based on this PV diagram, there will be a question in the entrance examination. Therefore, you must remember this. And you have to follow the sign convention while solving the problem. That you will understand in the forthcoming classes. So, all right. See, knowing of all this, now we are in a position to understand more about the heat engines. Okay.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.